Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the doubt class for CAT 2021 aspirants. Hope you guys can see me and hear me clearly. What I'll do is I'll just go online and check if the session is live. I can indeed see myself. Okay, adjust this a little bit and we are good to go. So as usual in these classes, what we do is we discuss doubts that have been sent by students. That will be our agenda for today as well. If you guys can see me and hear me clearly, you can use the chat window. You can use the chat window which is given to ask your doubt and get your queries clarified. Then first of all, for those of you who might be attending my class for the first time, my name is Ravi Handa. I have been teaching for CAT for close to 15 years. I started the website handagafanda.com a decade ago, through which I taught 20,000 plus students online. Good evening, Avinash. These days, I'm taking a lot of classes on YouTube, on the Unacademy app. If you want to know which class is happening when, I would recommend that you join my Telegram group, which is available on CAT Prep Online. You should be able to join it from there. Now, as a part of Unacademy, two types of courses are offered. One is the Plus courses, the other one is the Iconic courses. In the Plus courses, you get live classes, pretty similar to this one. And you get them in a structured way. That is, you do this, then this, then this, so on and so forth. In the Iconic one, what you do is, you're provided personal guidance, which is given to you by B-School grads from top colleges. So this is that particular program from, so we have people from IIM Ahmedabad and Bangalore and these top colleges who help you via a one-to-one live mentorship. What happens in these programs is you can call them up, you can discuss your doubts, and most importantly, you can discuss your exam strategy with them. If you're looking at plans, my recommendation is to go in for the six-month plan, which is for 16,400. You can use the coupon code HANDA to get an additional 10% off on the same. For the Iconic one, you can have a look at the 12-month plan, which is for 39,500. Once again, you can use the coupon code HANDA to get a 10% off on that. To be honest, you don't really need a 12-month plan until and unless you're looking at CAT 2022. If you're looking at CAT 2021, the Iconic plan will be available for 25,800, and that would be a much better choice in my opinion. So once again, the 25,800 plan if you need that one-on-one mentorship, and the 16,400 plan if you do not need that one-on-one mentorship. And in each of these places, you can use the coupon code HANDA to get the additional discount. And on that note, I think we can start off with the questions. We can start off with the doubts. If there is any other stuff that you would want to discuss, please let me know. I will try and cover that up. Otherwise, I'll go ahead and start with the questions which are given to us. So let's check. This is the first question which is given to me. 0.05 to the power. So this log is in power, base is root 20, and then we have a series inside it. Well, this does look a little bit complicated, I'm not gonna lie. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to figure out what the series is. So this series is 0.3 plus 0.03 plus 0.003 and so on till infinity. Now, how do you actually find this value out? There are two ways. One is that you can use the formula for the sum of the GP series. What is the formula? That is A upon 1 minus R, where R is the common ratio. In this case, A, or the first term, is 0.3, and the common ratio is 0.3, 0.03, and so on. So the common ratio is 1 by 10. Every next term is getting divided by 1 by 10. So this is 0.3 divided by 9 by 10. So 10 goes up, this becomes 3 by 9, or this becomes 1 by 3. That is one way of looking at it. That is one way of looking at it. Another way of looking at it is that you literally add this up. If you literally add this up, what will you get? After the point, you have a 3. Then 0, 3, so this becomes 0.33. Then another 3, so this becomes 0.333. Then another 3, and this goes on. So what is 0.33333333? 0.3333 is nothing else, but that is also 1 by 3. Which means my question has now kind of reduced to 0.05 log to the base of root 20 of 1 by 3. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to focus just on this part. If I focus just on this part, how much is this? This part is log of 1 by 3 to the base root 20, which can be written as log of 1 by 3 divided by log of root 20, which can be written as minus log 3 in the numerator, because log of 1 by 3 will be log of will be minus log 3, and my denominator will become half of log 20. This 2 goes up, so this becomes minus 2 log 3 divided by log 20, which becomes minus of log 9 by log 20. So the power, if you think about it, reduces to minus of log 9 by log 20. So Nidhi wants to know, when will the HKF mocks be available? Nidhi, we are waiting for the pattern to get declared. As soon as the pattern gets declared, we will be releasing those mocks. Rakesh, sure, you can send your LRDI doubts as well. I think in today's class also, I will be discussing one of the LRDI questions. I will be discussing one of the LRDI questions, I think, in the second half. Okay, so let's go ahead. My question was to find out the value. I don't have much space here. Are you guys okay with this? Can I rub this off? I hope you guys are okay with whatever I have written here, finding it out as 1 by 3. I'm rubbing this part off. Now, so basically what I've done is, I've reduced my question to 0.05 to the power of minus log 9 to the base 20, which effectively is 1 by 20, or rather 20 to the power of minus 1, the entire thing to the power of minus log 9 to the base 20. The minus 1 will get multiplied with this, so this will get reduced to 20 to the power of log 9 to the base 20, which is what? Which is nothing else but 9. Please note, a to the power of log of x to the base a is nothing else but x. Is nothing else but x. This is an identity that you can use. This is an identity that you can use to get the answer. And if you don't know this identity, perfectly fine. Let's say you don't know this. You reach till here and then you don't know the answer, what it is. So what you do is, you equate this with, suppose, x, where x is your answer. You take log on both sides. Whatever is in power comes down. So you have log 20 is log x, which will mean this log 9 to the base 20 can be written as log 9 by log 20. This log 20 goes to the other side, becomes log x by log 20. Log 20 and log 20 gets cancelled. You're left with x equal to 9. So either you can just look at it and say that the answer is 9. And if you cannot visualize that, if you do not know the formula that a to the power of log x to the base a is actually equal to x, in case you do not know that, just take log on both sides, which will still lead you to the same answer. Are you guys okay with this? Can I go to the next question? Please type a yes if you are okay with this and you want me to go to the next question. Avinash, Rakesh, Nidhi, hope you guys are fine with these values that I have written here. Okay, Gaurav, I'll go to the next question. So this first question was sent to us by Angshuk Dam. The next question is sent to us by Nikhil Vashisht. Nikhil Vashisht. It says, in movie K3G, there is a family of 3 generations having 8 members. There are exactly 2 married couples in the family and the remaining 4 members are unmarried. So by default, in questions like this, there are some things that you should assume. A male is married to a female. No one has a child out of a wedlock. So those things are kind of assumed. A's granddaughter B is an engineering student, which means A must be married to someone. They should have a child. That child, whether it's a male or a female, I don't know that, should be married to someone. They should have a child. And that child is B. And B is a granddaughter who is an engineering student. Are you guys okay with this? There are 2 married couples in the family. So these are my 2 married couples. These are, so A is married with someone and B's parents. These are my 2 married couples. Everyone else is unmarried. So B is unmarried. Then C's mother D is a police officer. Now C's mother D is a police officer. That is possible in 2 ways. One is that, you know, C is here, the mother is D. The other one is that C is here and the mother is D. So basically, we don't know which generation C and D are in, but C's mother, so D is a female who is in the police, while his maternal aunt E is a professor. Okay? So maternal aunt E, maternal, so she is from the mother's side. D is the mother. His, that means C, is a professor. Once again, I do not know whether, where they are married or what is happening. F's son G is a banker. So that's another part that I'm not aware of. So wherever F is, F's son, so F should be married to someone. F's son G is a banker while her son-in-law, so F is a female, while her son-in-law runs a hotel with his son. So that means F's son G, so G is a male and a banker, she should have a daughter also who is married to the son-in-law H. And then H runs a hotel with his son. So there are multiple things which are available now. Let me just rephrase. First condition was that A is, B is the granddaughter. So A is in top generation, B is in the bottom generation. C, D, E, we were not aware of what is happening with C, D, E. Then we were given that F has 2 children, presumably. G is a banker and F's daughter is married to H who runs a hotel with a son-in-law. This places F in the top generation. Now, if F is in the top generation, the only possible way this is possible is if A and F are married. So let's do that. A is married to F. F is a female. That means A has to be a male. Rakesh, no, we don't have to assume that A has a spouse. That's a possibility. But now the possibility got confirmed when I had F, you know, in the top generation. So A is married to F. Now, they have, you know, definitely a male child who is G, who is a banker. They have a female child who is married to H. And H has a son, and H and the son, they run a hotel. So this is there. Now, what are the possibilities? What are the possibilities? Now C, mother is a police officer and E is a maternal aunt. The only way that is possible in this diagram is C is the hotelier's son, son of D, who is a police officer, and A and F actually have a third female child. A and F actually have a third female child, E, who is a professor. They also have a granddaughter. So who is the granddaughter? B is the granddaughter, who is an engineering student. And this will be my final diagram. Are you guys okay with the final diagram that I have obtained here? Profession of C and stuff. Rakesh, Avinash, Gaurav. Because once you get the final diagram, there isn't, you know, much that is left in the question. All that you will need to do now, all that you will need to do now is just get the answers. So C's profession, so C is a hotelier. Who are the married couples? A and F. And H and D, these are my married couples. H and D here, the hotelier and the police officer, and A and F. A and F are the other married couple. So, one of my batches just started. One of my batches just started for CAT 2021. You guys can go ahead and join that. In this course, I'll be covering permutation and combination primarily. Permutation and combination primarily starts from Monday. Starts from Monday. As a matter of fact, I'm taking a special class on PNC tonight at 8:15. You guys are more than welcome to join that as well. We'll discuss the basics of PNC in that. So this is a data sufficiency question. This is a data sufficiency question. Here, we are given, is G greater than H? Is G greater than H? Which statement is enough to find that out? Now, statement 1 says G plus 3 is greater than H plus 2, which essentially means that G is greater than H minus 1. Now, if you know that G is greater than H minus 1, can you comment on the comparison between G and H? You can't. The second statement says G cube is greater than H cube. G cube is greater than H cube. So can you determine something from this? Once again, you can't. Because, you know, my normal tendency says that, okay, if I take G cube, if I take cube root of both sides, that is okay. And I will get G is greater than H. But let me just tell you, say, for example, this will fail in case of, say, fractional numbers, I believe, this will fail. For example, we know 1 by 8 is greater than 1 by 64. So half, I think there it will work. So G cube by H cube. So G by H whole cube, if they are positive. What about negative values? So I have minus 8 greater than minus 64. If I have great, one negative and one positive, No, if we are given that, so for positive negative will be taken care of. Positive negative will be taken care of. So minus 8, minus 2, and minus 4. I think this works. I think this works. You know, when confused, what's the best way to solve these questions? The best way to solve these questions is you try and plot a graph of this. You try and plot a graph of this. Now, when you try and plot a graph of this, at 0 it is 0, at 1 it is 1, at 2 it is 8, at 3 it is 27, and so on. Very similarly, in the negative terms, at 0 it is 0, at minus 1 it is minus 1, at minus 2 it is minus 8, at minus 3 it is minus 97, so it is, you know, the graph for g cube and h, the graph for fx cube will look something like this. Now, as the value of x is increasing, as the value of x is increasing, very similarly, the value of x cube is also increasing. So if I have a is greater than b, then I can say that a cube is greater than b cube, and both of them can be derived from each other, which means second statement is valid. If I'm given g cube is greater than h cube, then I can say that g is greater than h. That means second statement is enough and first statement is not. Now, it will not fail for negative and positive because the fundamental premise, what you are saying, Vikas, would have been valid in case of x square. What you are saying would have been valid in case of x square. But in case of x cube, as a matter of fact, I believe in case of any odd power of x, the relationship would be valid. In case of any odd power of x, the relationship would be valid. Can I go to the next question now? Vikas, Gaurav, Avinash, Rakesh. If you guys are okay with this, should I go to the next question? Okay. So, I think someone was asking in the beginning that do we discuss LR questions also? So, yes, we do discuss LR questions. This particular question was sent to me by Ishan. So, it's a long question. I will, try to solve this. G8 is an association of Southeast Asian countries to resolve their trade disputes. Every year, 24 countries elect their chairperson. For this, several rounds of voting are done. Okay. For the post of the chairperson, only member countries of the G8 can nominate at most one candidate per country. For the post of the chairperson of the year 2007-2008, Audi, Boxer, Coffee and Dimply, basically A, B, C, D are contending. So we have four contenders, A, B, C, and D. In each round of voting, the candidate with the minimum number of votes is eliminated. Okay. So minimum is eliminated such that the person with the maximum votes at the last of the voting process is designated as the chairperson. So suppose in the first round you had A, B, C, D, then A got eliminated. In the next round, you will have B, C, D. B will get eliminated. In the next round, you will have only C, D. Suppose D gets eliminated, then C will be your overall winner. So how many rounds do you need? You need three rounds. So wherever I have some empty space. Okay. I think this is fairly empty. So what I need is three rounds. Round 1, round 2, and round 3. And A, B, C, and D. These are the four people who are there, who are getting the votes. How many votes they're getting, that I don't know. Let's go ahead with the other conditions. So we have used the first three. Then, while voting, the member countries whose members are in contention can cast a vote for only one member in the contention. Okay. So let's say if, Audi comes from India and I am the representative from India, I can cast a vote for only one member. I can cast a vote for only one member. A country is eligible to vote for at most two candidates in the voting process. So suppose in the first round, I vote for A. In the next round, I can vote for B. But in the third round, it has to be A or B. You know, I cannot keep on changing my votes. I cannot keep on changing my votes. Candidates Audi and Boxer retain their votes from all the previous rounds as they were contentions for in the post for the chairperson. Okay. So suppose B got 63 votes in round 2, then he will get all of these 63 votes in round 3 also. If he continues to participate, they will carry their votes. So basically what it's trying to say is A's voters are loyalists. B's voters are loyalists. C's voters are flunky. They keep on changing their vote. Voters for D are also, they can keep on changing their votes. A and B are loyalists. They will not change their votes. 25% of those who voted for Coffee in round 1 voted for Boxer in round 2. Okay, so Coffee in round 1, if that was X, out of this 4X, X voted for Boxer in round 2. Now let me draw these lines, might be a little bit cleaner. Trying to draw the grid. Okay, so this is my grid. This is my grid. So from this 4x, x votes will move here. I will keep that in mind. Then, those who voted for Dimpli in round 1 voted either for Boxer or Coffee in round 2. So, whoever voted for Dimple in round 1, he voted either for Boxer or for Coffee in round 2. Which means D did not exist in round 2 and round 3. See, only then, if all of them are voting, okay, maybe D existed. Someone else voted for D. But these all votes of D, they went to either B or C. Are you guys okay till here? All votes for D went either to B or C. Then half of those who voted for Coffee in round 1 voted for Boxer in round 3. So from this 4x, 2x voted here, 2x voted here. Again, I'll keep that in mind. All countries whose candidates are in contention voted for their own candidates as long as they are in contention. Okay, so they will, if I'm from India and my Indian team is there, I'll vote for my team only. The following table gives me some more information about how the voting happened. So in round 2, total number of votes is 163 and 147. So 163 votes here. How is this that the number of votes are reducing? Well, okay, so this could be a reason for elimination, that there are people who voted can cast a vote for only one member. Okay. See, these guys, so the guys who are voting for A, B, C, and D, the guys who are voting for, who belong to the countries of A, B, C, and D, they cannot vote if their guy is ruled out. See, because they can only vote, while voting, whose members are in contention can vote for only one member in their contention. So they can only vote for their own country. They cannot vote for anyone else. I'll keep that in mind. So now let's look at the votes. In round 1, A got maximum votes or 60. So A got 60. In round, what are the other values? 60, minimum is 24. Then 64 for B and 39 for C. So 64 for B, 39 for C. The minimum who got eliminated here was 24. 163 and 147. Okay. So first of all, D got eliminated here. C got eliminated here. These are the only people who are there. Now, how many votes? That's the key criteria. Out of one, yes, Rakesh, I'll do that. So, Rakesh, multiple things are happening. I've put in the values in the table. I'll just quickly go through all the conditions once again. That for the post, only the member countries can vote. So, only they are allowed to vote. And they can nominate at least one. Only member countries can nominate at most one candidate. For the post, there are four candidates which are contesting. In each candidate, the candidate with the minimum votes is eliminated and the person with the last maximum number of votes wins. So what we can see here is in the first round, minimum value was 24, got eliminated. In the second round, C's 39 was minimum. So C got eliminated. And A and B are there in the final round. Then while voting, the member countries whose members are in contention. So there are four countries, A, B, C, and D, where whichever countries they belong to, they can vote for only one member in their contention. And later we are given, they can vote only for their own candidates. Which means that from round one to round two, you lost one vote. From round 1 to round 2, you lost one vote. Who's one vote? Country D. From round 2 to round 3, you lost one vote. Who's one vote? Country C. Are you guys okay with this? Losing of votes? If this number is 163, theoretically, this number should have been 164 and this number should have been 162. This is not given to us, but this is given to us as 147. That means there is a gap of 15. So there are 15 more people who got eliminated. From round 1 to round 2, one person got eliminated. From round, that person was the person for D. From round 2 to round 3, one person got eliminated, the person from country C. But the loss that we are seeing, we are actually seeing a loss of 15. Yes, round 3 is lesser by 15. See, these 39 votes, they can go to somewhere else. I don't know where they are going, but they can go to someone else. It's possible that these guys go here. I don't know where they are going, but they can go to other locations. Like, these 4X, X came here. These 24, some came here, some came here. So these 39 can also go. We'll figure out who goes where. Then one of the conditions for elimination, one of the conditions for elimination is that a member country is eligible to vote for at most two candidates. So, you know, one guy got eliminated because his candidate got kicked out. D. One guy got eliminated because his candidate got kicked out. These 15 got eliminated because they can vote for at most two people. There must be people who voted for D in round 1 and who voted for C in round 2, and that's why they are out. Are you guys okay with this? That out of these 15 are those people who voted. Who voted for D in round 1, C in round 2, and that's why these 15 got eliminated. So let's check for these 15. So this 24, you know, maybe I'll use a different color for these 15 so that it's clear. So there are 15 candidates. These are the candidates who voted for in round 1 for D, in round 2 for C. Where are these 15 candidates? So this 24 is made up of these 15. And these 15 are going here. Now, there are 9 more candidates who are left. Out of them, this one is the guy from D. This one is the guy from D who cannot vote anymore. The other eight must have landed here, because this 24 we are given, the only place this 24 can go to is B or C. These 24 guys, one of the conditions was people who voted for D in round 1, this condition. Those who voted for D in round 1 voted either for Boxer or Coffee in round 2. Are you guys okay with this? Not 9, Gaurav, 8 voted for B. 8 voted for B because one guy got eliminated. Gaurav, that's an important point that might create a problem for you later. So you need to understand that not 9, but 8 got vote, 8 voted for B in round 1. Are you okay with this? Everyone? I will go ahead now. I'll assume you guys are okay with this and I'll go ahead now. So 163 is the total number of votes in round 2. 64 and 39 is 103, which means 60 votes here. As a matter of fact, see, we are given anyone who gets whatever votes here, A never loses his votes. So these 60 votes will continue. Something might get added up. In this 64 also, this 64 will get continued and something might get added up. Or rather, whatever was the value here, that will continue. So now you can try and visualize one thing. How is this 39 made up of? What is this 39 made up of? 39 will be made up of, will anyone go from here to here? No. Will anyone go from B to here? No. Will anyone go from C to here? Yes. Will anyone come from D to here? Yes. So, this 39 can only be made up of two parts. One part of that is 15, which is coming from D. So the other part should be coming from here, which is 24. 24 plus 15 gives me 39. Which tells me that from this 4x, 24 is coming here and x is going here. That means 24 is actually equal to 3x, or x is actually equal to 8. Once I have that x is equal to 8, I have eliminated, so once I have this particular value, must have been 32. So from 32, 24 came here, another 8 came here. Are you okay with the value of 32 with 8 and 24? 32 with 8 and 24. Now, what was my original value for this? 60 and 32 is 92. 92 and 24 is 116. 164 minus 116 is 48. So this will be, this 48 will continue. 48 plus 8 plus 8, which is giving me 64. Now 48 plus something something. 2x. 2x I know is 16. 2x I know is 16. So how much will this be? This I know is 60 only. This I know is 60 only. So 48 plus 16 I know. Where is this 16 coming from? How do I highlight this? So 48, this is following. This 32. This 32 will be split into 16. 15 here. And 1 is this guy. So this 32 is 16 plus 15 plus 1. These 32 votes go, 16 go here, 15 go here, and 1 comes here. Are you okay with these? Are you okay with these? What other votes? So all this 60, 60, 60 comes here. 48, 48, 48 comes here. Out of this 32, out of this 32, 16 here, 15 here, 1 is eliminated. Out of these 24, 15 is eliminated. This 15, 1 is eliminated here, which is the person from D. 8 more votes are there. So these 8 votes come here, which will make my grand total 60 plus 15, 75. 48 plus 16 is 48 plus 16 is 64 plus 8 or 72. So these are my final vote tallies. Are you guys okay with the final vote tallies? Good question. Good question. I have to, you know, understand the complete split. Understand the complete split. Please tell me if you have a problem with any of these values. I'll happily explain that value again. If you have a problem with any of these values, please ask. I will happily explain that value again. If not, I'll just go ahead and explain the questions. This was sent to us by Ishan Sharma. Ishan Sharma, I hope you are there in class. It is hard. I have never said that this is easy. Which of the following is true? 16 candidates who voted for D in round 1 voted for coffee in round 2. So 16 for D in round 1, coffee in round 2. No, that number is 15. It is not 16, but 15 such candidates are there. Audi won the election in round 3 by a margin of 3 votes. Yes, Audi did win in round 3 with a margin of 3 votes. So option 2 is correct. Only B is my answer. For D, I will repeat again. See, D had a total of 24 votes, which is given to us in the question. What will happen to these 24 votes? In the end, we are given, look at this reduction. From 163 to 147, the reduction in votes, from 163 to 147, there is a reduction of 16. Whereas the reduction should have been of 1. That means the extra deduction of 15, this 15 is coming from people who voted twice. So condition number 5. A member country is eligible to vote for at most two people. So if there is someone who voted for D in round 1, then D got eliminated, so he couldn't do anything. In the next round, he decides to vote for C. And then C also get eliminated. So now he has voted for C, he has voted for D, he has voted for two separate countries. Those two countries are no longer eligible to, you know, contest in round 3. So these 15 guys will have to sit out. So out of 24, 15 guys are sitting out. One is eliminated. The other 8. So these 15 must have voted for C. The other 8 voted for B. And the other 8 continued to vote for B. That is what is happening. Why minus 1? Because anyone, so the person from D, see, suppose D belongs to India, Indians will only vote for their own country. Person. Now, if Indians will only vote for Dimple and Dimple is no longer there, then they can't vote. See, condition number 10, all countries whose candidates are in contention voted for their own candidates. So as long as they are in contention, they will vote for their own candidates. Once they are not in contention, they can cast for only one member. So if they have already voted for Dimple, they cannot vote for anyone else. Yes, Abhishek, it is time consuming. That's the reason why I'm picking this up. Ishan had sent this as a doubt. I wanted to clarify. This is a good question. Good concepts are used in this. That's why I wanted to pick this up. So forget about the time part. But let's say if you have any questions, follow-ups, doubts for this, please ask. No, not at all. Should not be attempted in the exam. The idea is you should be comfortable with these concepts. Not attempt this in the exam. I'll go ahead. How many voted for Dimpy in round 1, voted for Boxer in round 2? So D in round 1 is Boxer in round 2. So that is this 8, the pink 8. Number of votes for candidates Coffee in round 1. Coffee in round 1 is 32. See, once you have the table, it isn't difficult. Among those who voted for Coffee in round 2, 39 voted for Coffee in round 2. From these 39, how many were eligible to vote in round 3? Basically, from this 39, 15 people are ineligible. 15 people are ineligible because they are voting for D also and so on. There is 24 people who are left who are eligible. There are 24 people who are left who are eligible. What percentage voted for Audi in round 1? So, among these, who has voted for Audi? You know, this 8 is here. This 8 continues. The extra 8 come from here. So from this 24, 15 voted for Audi in round 1. So that will be 24 were eligible. Out of these 24, so out of this 39, okay, I think I will, you know, 39 people are there. Out of this 39, 15 got eliminated because they voted for C and D. One got eliminated because, you know, that guy belonged to country C, belonged to C's country. 8 voted for B and 15 voted for A. What is the question asking me? From those who are eligible, how many voted for A? So 15 out of 23 voted for A. And what is 15 out of 23? 15 out of 23 is 65.21, which is option D. Minus 1. This minus 1. How many people are voting for coffee in round 3? Which country does coffee come from? Suppose coffee comes from China. So the Chinese guy will vote for coffee in round 1. The Chinese guy will vote for coffee in round 2. The Chinese guy, who will he vote for in round 3? He cannot vote. The Chinese guy is only allowed to vote for the Chinese candidate. Once the Chinese candidate is not there, he is not allowed to vote anymore. So this is the Chinese guy. This one person that I'm saying gets eliminated is the Chinese guy. Rakesh, I think a good example for this would be, maan lo, jaise bachpan mein nahi hota tha ki cricket ke khelne ja rahe ho aur bat tumhara hai. Agar tumhari batting ho gayi aur tum ho gaye out, to tum kya bolte ho ki nahi, main to bat leke ja raha hu, main nahi khelna. Exact same thing the Chinese are doing here. Jaise hi unka candidate hara, wo bole ki nahi, main nahi khelna, main to ja raha hu, main nahi kar raha voting. That's what's happening. जैसे ही ये जो माइनस वन हुआ है, ये क्यों हुआ है? ये डी से कोई, अगर तुम कंट्री सोचो, मुझे तो डी से कोई कंट्री नहीं याद आ रही है, डेनमार्क. तो डेनमार्क का बंदा, वो वोट किया पहले राउंड में डी को, देन ही रियलाइज उसका आदमी खेल ही नहीं रहा है और हिज मैन हैज बीन एलिमिनेटेड. सो दिस वन गाय इज द डेनमार्क गाय हु विल नो लॉन्गर वोट. This one guy is the Chinese guy who voted for coffee. So this Chinese guy will no longer vote. Is this okay now, Rakesh? The Denmark guy who is voting for Denmark, he will no longer vote. The Chinese guy who is voting for China, he will no longer vote. So that's why the minus one part is coming. Okay, we have another question from Manas Gupta. An equilateral triangle with side 6 is inscribed in a circle. So, ye raha ji aapka triangle. Isko kar diya circle mein inscribe. Equilateral triangle ki side hai 6. तो इसका रेडियस कितना होगा? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल भाई, ये आर है, ये आर है, ये 120 डिग्री है, विच मीन्स आर रूट 3 इज इक्वल टू 6, विच मीन्स माई रेडियस इज इक्वल टू 2√3. देन व्हाट इज गिवन कि आपने, विच इन टर्न इज इंस्क्राइब्ड इन अ रेगुलर हेक्सागन. So, let me make the circle first. And now let's inscribe this circle in a regular hexagon. ये हो गया जी हमारा हेक्सागन. अब मुझे इसका रेडियस तो पता है. नाउ इफ आई जॉइन द सेंटर विद द टू वर्टिसेस, I get an equilateral triangle. And what is the height of this equilateral triangle? The height of this equilateral triangle is the radius. So height of the equilateral triangle is root 3 by 2 times the side, which is the radius. We are given root 3 by 2 times the side. Radius ki value to humne nikal rakhi hai. We have found out the radius as 2 root 3, which means side comes out as root 3 cancels, side comes out as 4. Once I have the side as 4, what is the area? Area is 3 root 3 by 2 into side square, which is 3 root 3 by 2 into 16. So this is 8. 8 into 3 root 3 comes out as 24 root 3, which is option 3. Are you guys okay with this? 24 root 3 as the option here. Rakesh, Gaurav, Abhishek. This one was a little bit straightforward. Manas Gupta had sent this as a doubt. Now, these are couple of special classes which are coming up. There is a special class today at 7 p.m. where I'll talk about some must-do LRDI sets. This is available on the Unacademy app. You can go ahead and join that. For geometry, I'm taking classes on YouTube Monday to Thursday. So we'll be covering circles in this. In the month of August, I plan to cover coordinate and mensuration, which will be the two essential topics here that would be left. In case in any video you found any inappropriate content, there will be a link in the description where you can report that. We have also started a channel for marketing professionals. The link for that, again, all these links are in the description. So this is a channel for marketing professionals. We have started a channel for class 12 students for the IPMAT exam. That's also there in the description. And for attending the special class, you will need to install the Unacademy app. You can get it from the Play Store. And once you have the app, this is the process. You know, you just need to click plus, click on cat, and you can get the subscription from there. Another reminder, tomorrow there is a scholarship test that you can take part in, which will be at 12 noon. You can use the coupon code HANDA in that, and the toppers get the course for free. There is a batch for achievers. This is for campus placements. Some of you might be in your final year who might be taking part in this, so they can use it here. Avinash, I'm not sure if I got those. Avinash, just send a top-up email on that. I'll probably cover it up in one of the other classes. Avinash, when did you send it? Avinash Kumar Singh, when did you send it? I think I checked today morning. There was nothing which is there. I think I've covered everything which was there till the morning. For the enrolled students, we have Unacademy has an Ask a Doubt feature where you can click a picture, send it to us. Either me or someone from our team will clarify that doubt for you. And on Thursday, I'm surprised to have missed that. Avinash, just send a top-up on that. Reminder on the same email. You have sent it on hkfdoubt@gmail.com, I hope. That's a doubt email ID that we are using. I hope, Avinash, you have sent on that. To the others, you can also send your doubts on hkfdoubt@gmail.com. I take one doubt class every weekend, and I try to cover as much as possible in that. And on that note, I would like to end this class. Hope you guys learned something from it. Hope you guys liked it. Do not forget to press the like button and also subscribe to our channel. That's it for today. Or not for today. See you at 7 when we will be discussing LRDI must-do sets on the Unacademy app. Please download the app and use HANDA as the referral code over there.